A blessed day to everyone. My name is Andrian Olasiman, and here we are again for another healthy spiritual reminder inspired by God's holy words. Amen. Glory to God for this day na naman po na mapag-usapan natin yung message ni Lord, another revelation from God to us all. But before anything else, I just want to share to you that a good friend of mine commented to one of my videos that I have posted in YouTube, and he told me that it's better for me to have opening prayer and a closing prayer. Prayer between from the beginning of the video and at the end of the video. And I praise God for his life, because I do believe it's not his idea. It's a reminder from God through his life to me. Because actually po, nagpipray po ako before po ako gumagawa ng video. Because I do believe in God's word in John 15:5 that Jesus said, "I am the vine, you are the branches. Whoever abides in me will bear much fruit. But apart from me, from Jesus Christ, we can do nothing." That's why I always pray, ask God for wisdom and knowledge, ask God for strength, that I can do these things. God says in Philippians 4:13, "I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength." Amen. So I always depend on Jesus Christ, on the Holy Spirit, to do His works through my life. I am just an empty vessel. Mouthpiece lang po ako. So I pray before doing these videos. But glory to God, God is reminding, the reason why that I'm doing that, I'm not praying in video, because I'm thinking of mapapahaba pa yung video. Gusto ko lang siya ma-short, kasi I do believe marami pong mga tao na ayaw ng mahabang video. Gusto lang short and straight to the point na topic. But God is reminding me today through the life of my friend that I should not compromise. It's not about you. It's not about me. It's all about God. Amen. It's all about for His glory alone. Amen. It's all about worshiping Him. Amen. So I praise God for the life of my good friend na nagre-remind sa akin that we should have this opening and closing prayer. Amen. So without further ado, let's pray. Amen. Lord, hallelujah, Lord, hallelujah, Lord Jesus Christ, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. We exalt and glorify your name, Lord. Lord, unang-una po, Lord, we humble down ourselves, Lord, and we ask for forgiveness, Lord. Lord, forgive us, Lord, with all of our sins, Lord. With all, sa lahat na aming mga nagawa, na isip at nasalita po, Lord. Lord, patawad po, Lord, sa aming mga kasalanan po, Lord. Lord, salamat, Lord, sa word niyo po, Lord, in 1 John 1:9, Lord, that if we confess our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive all of our sins, Lord, and cleanse us from all of our unrighteousness. Lord, thank you so much, Lord, that every time we ask for forgiveness, Lord, you are faithful, Lord, to forgive all of our sins, Lord, our past, present, and future sins, Lord. Thank you so much, Lord, that even though we are unfaithful to you in times, Lord, many times we are unfaithful to you, Lord, but still, Lord, you remain faithful sa mga buhay po namin, Lord. Lord, salamat po, Lord. And Lord, thank you, Lord, for this opportunity, Lord, that we can talk na naman po, Lord, about your holy message, Lord, yung revelation niyo po, Lord, sa araw na ito, Lord. Lord, I pray, Lord, that all of us, Lord, will have an open mind, open heart, Lord Jesus Christ, that we will receive your message, Lord, clearly, Lord. And Lord, hindi lang po kami, Lord, makikinig, Lord, but we will really, Lord, doers, Lord, sa word niyo po, Lord. Lord, help us, Lord, to apply whatever we learn from your revelation, Lord, sa araw na ito, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. And Lord, we rebuke, Lord, Satan, Lord, and all the works of the enemy in Jesus Christ's name. Hallelujah, Lord. Lord, thank you so much, Lord. Thank you sa lahat-lahat, Lord, sa provisions, sa security, sa good health. Thank you, Lord, for your presence in our life, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for your presence in our lives. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. All the glory belongs to you alone, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We love you, Lord, through your Son, in Jesus Christ's name. Amen. So the topic that God wants us to talk about today, boys, I believe is why God created you and me. Naitanong niyo po ba ito sa sarili niyo? Bakit nga ba ako isinilang dito sa kamunduhan? Why am I born in this world? Ano po, napasok po ito sa isipan ko po by God's wisdom nung I think it's a movie na narinig ko na mahirap po yung sitwasyon niya, and sabi ng character na yun na bakit ako ipinanganak dito sa kamunduhan? Napanak ba ako para lang talaga mag-suffer sa sitwasyon na ito, maghirap. Now, I believe po, may mga tao na ngayon nag-iisip, especially sa sitwasyon natin ngayon sa crisis na ito na mapapaisip tayo na bakit ba ako isinilang sa mundo? Sinilang lang ba talaga ako para mahirapan lang, para pasakitan? Amen. So, today po, God is reminding us or God is revealing to us why He created you and me. Bakit niya tayo nilikha? And the main reason why God created us is to worship Him. Yun lang po. No more, no less, to worship Him. To worship God. To bring glory to His name. To exalt His name. To glorify Him. To praise Him. To love Him. Amen. As a matter of fact, ito po yung word ni Lord na binigay sa atin. Hindi lang po isa lang, but three word Bible verses na binigay po sa atin ni Lord. First word na binigay sa atin ni Lord is in Matthew chapter 22 verse 37 to 39. Sabi ni Lord, Jesus replied, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the first and greatest commandment. A second is equally important. Love your neighbor as you love yourself." Amen. So ito po yung two greatest commandment ni Lord sa atin, to love God above with all of our heart, with all of our soul, and with all of our mind. Ano po ibig sabihin nun? Lahat sa kanya, 100% sa kanya, no less, no more, no less. Lahat talaga, lahat ng attention mo sa kanya, lahat ng pag-ibig mo sa kanya, all the affection, all the worship, all the praise sa kanya. And loving Him is our way of worshiping God. Amen? So, may sasabi nyo sa akin siguro, may tatanong nyo sa akin siguro, no, kung ibibigay ko lahat sa Panginoon, lahat, 100% sa Kanya, walang na matitira sa pamilya ko, sa mga kaibigan ko, sa kapwa ko. No, that's why God is very specific sa commandment niya na una talaga niya nagsabi na love God above all else. Kasi when you love God, siya na rin po ang mag-uutos sa inyo na love your family. Sabi nga po niya, oh, second is equally important. Love your neighbor as you love yourself. You love God first, that's why God's love nag-overflow din sa buhay mo. And hindi mo siya mapipigilan. Mag-overflow po talaga yung pagmamahal na yan at ma-share mo din sa mga tao sa paligid mo. Amen po? So, that's the reason why God has created us, have created you and me. The reason why you were born in this world is to worship Him, is to love Him with all of your heart, mind, and soul. Amen? 100% sa Kanya lahat. Amen? The second verse na binigay sa atin ni Lord is in 1 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 31. Sabi ni Lord, "So whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do it for the glory of God." Amen? Another way to worship God, another reason why we were born in this world is to bring glory to His name alone. Whatever you do, whether you eat, whether you drink, or whatever you do, bring glory to His name. What, for example, when you pray, when you eat your meal ngayon po, 3 times a day, have you been praying before eating your meal? Amen? Siguro hindi tayo nagpe-pray. Amen po. Kumakain lang tayo agad-agad. Amen? So sabi ni Lord, whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, you should bring glory to the name of God. You should praise God for the blessing that we receive. Especially ngayon sa panahon na ito na taghirap. Taghirap ang panahon natin ngayon. Yung iba wala na makain pa tayo. We are blessed. Marami, may pagkain pa rin tayo. Tumataba nga tayo eh. Glory to God. But I pray for the people also na nahihirapan ngayon na ma-provide din yung mga needs nila. Anyway po, that's why God created us. It's to worship Him. It's to bring glory to His name. Amen po. And He even gave us a commandment, which is part of the 10 commandments. And at the same time, it's a warning to us all if we do not worship Him. Ito po yung sabi ni Lord in Exodus chapter 20 verses 1 to 4. Sabi ni Lord, "I am the Lord your God who rescued you from the land of Egypt, the place of your slavery. You must not have other God but me. Amen. Huwag kang magkaroon ng ibang Diyos-Diyosan, kundi si Lord lang, si God lang. You must not make yourself an idol of any kind or an image of anything in the heavens, on the earth, or in the sea. You must not bow down to them or worship them. For I, the Lord your God, am a jealous God, who will not tolerate your affection for any other gods. I lay the sins of the parents upon the children. The entire family is affected, even children in the third and fourth generations of those who reject me. But I lavish unfailing love for 1,000 generations on those who love me and obey my commandments. Diniretso ko na po sa verse until verse 6. So ito po yung warning sa atin ni Lord na don't create a different God that you worship. Only worship our one true God, a living God. You know po, itong topic, itong verse na ito, very wide siya, na pwede po natin dito nga tayo may another topic tayo dito eh. But for now po, mag-focus po tayo sa sabi ni Lord na we should not be worshiping other gods. You should not even make an image of a different God, but we should only have to worship Him alone. Ito po yung consequences ni Lord when we worship a different God. Sabi ni Lord, I lay the sins of the parents upon their children. The entire family is affected. Amen. Even children in the third and fourth generations of those who reject me. Amen. But, sabi ni Lord, but I lavish unfailing love for 1,000 generations on those who love me and obey my commandments. Amen. So, yun po ang consequences if we worship a different God rather than our living God. Amen. So yun po ang gustong ibahagi ni Lord sa araw na ito po, that the reason why God created you is for us to worship Him alone. Amen po. So, paano po ba natin ma-worship si Lord? Yun po ang nasabi po natin kanina, di ba? Is to love Him with all of our heart, mind, and soul, and to bring glory to His name. Amen? But, meron pong revelation si Lord sa atin po na kasi po, we cannot face God face to face. Matutunaw po tayo. We cannot face Him na siya po yung worship natin direct, si God the Father. That's the reason why we have our Holy Trinity. Amen. Some people would ask, why do you have three gods? No, we don't have three gods. Only one God, but three persona. Amen po. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. God the Father, we could not worship Him directly po. Kasi po, we are all sinners. At siya very holy. Matutunaw po tayo, mamamatay po tayo when we face Him. And that's the reason why God send Jesus Christ sa buhay po natin. It's God the Father Himself through the life of Jesus Christ. Amen? Bumaba dito sa kamanduhan para makakonect sa atin po. Siya na ang gumawa ng paraan para tayo po freely worship Him, but through Jesus Christ. Amen? Kasi sabi po ni Lord in John 14:6, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me, through Jesus Christ. So, whenever we worship God, we worship through Jesus Christ. Amen? Para makapag-worship tayo ni God din po. Amen? So, that's the reason why Jesus Christ has been born din po. In order for us to connect to God the Father. He is our mediator, amen po, to God. So, we worship Him. That's why we always pray in Jesus' name. Kasi we worship God through Jesus Christ, but it's still God Himself. At the same time po, Jesus Christ is not here anymore, physically speaking. Wala na po siya. Nag-ascend na po siya sa heaven on the after His resurrection, nung namatay siya sa cross, sa Calvary. Amen? After, I think, 40 days, nag-ascend po siya sa heaven in the flesh din po. So, and that's the reason why we have the Holy Spirit. Amen? When He ascended to heaven po, nag-release po siya ng Holy Spirit. Amen? To those who believe in Jesus Christ, they receive the Holy Spirit. Amen? So, in this way po, we continue to worship God through Holy Spirit, which is with us right now. Hindi na siya, natin siya nakikita because He is a Holy Spirit. He is a Spirit. So, we can worship God through the Holy Spirit na kasama natin ngayon. Amen po. So, yun po ang gusto i-reveal sa atin ni Lord sa araw na ito na the reason why we are created by God is to worship Him in spirit and in truth. Amen po. And I believe the reason why God is reminding us today about worshiping Him kasi po we have forgotten it. We have forgotten why we are created. We have forgotten that we should be worshiping God. Amen po. I believe po this COVID virus was made not by God, but God allowed this to happen in our lives po, for us to be reminded po na we should be worshiping Him alone. Kasi po, before this COVID-19, before this pandemic, we are worshiping a different God already. We are already worshiping money. We are already worshiping our possessions. We are already worshiping our careers. We are even worshiping our family. We have forgotten God already. Amen? That's why God is reminding us today po. Maybe no, kung tayong lahat, we start to worship God in spirit and in truth po talaga. Worshiping Him in heart, in soul, by all of our soul, heart, and mind, truthfully, heartily, by glorifying His name. I believe po, itatapos na ni Lord yung COVID virus na ito. Kung lahat tayo magre-repent at mag-worship sa Kanya through the Holy Spirit, through Jesus Christ, to the God the Father. Amen? So, this is a reminder to us all po na start worshiping God. Forget all other things, especially right now na you are in your house right now, lockdown, curfew, hindi kayo makalabas, walang trabaho. You start worshiping God. Amen? You know po, hindi po ito kawalan. As God says in Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, God says, "Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you." Seeking God is one way of worshiping Him, knowing Him, having a relationship with Him through reading His Word, through reading the Bible, is worshiping Him. At hindi ito kawalan kasi promise po ni Lord that all of these things will be added unto you. If you seek God, if you worship Him, amen po. So all of the things that you need, your food, protection, good health, healing, He will give it to you once you just start worshiping Him again. Amen po. So, I pray that you receive this message. No, I believe this is really the revelation of God sa atin ngayon po. So, especially sa panahon ngayon, we forgotten to worship God. We should worship Him alone. That's why God created you and me. That's why you were born in this world, to worship Him alone, not to worship money, not to worship your possession, not even to worship your family, your kids, your wife, not even to worship your physical appearance. No, only to worship Him, God alone, because He is the source of everything. Amen po. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. I pray, I hope na yun lang po ang gustong i-reveal sa atin ni Lord po. And I hope that you understand this message po. I hope and pray that you receive this message. I hope that there is a revelation sa buhay po natin. Maybe you have forgotten God. Maybe you have forgotten to worship God. Amen. Start worshiping Him now. Amen. So, yun lang po ang gusto i-remind sa atin ni Lord. I hope and pray that you receive this message. And thank you. Thank you so much for listening, for viewing this video. I pray that God has revealed something in your life. Amen. So, as I have said before, we need to have a opening and closing prayer. So, let's pray po. Hallelujah, Lord, Heavenly Father. We thank you so much, Lord, for this opportunity, for this time that you have given to us, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for the revelation that you have given to us, the answer to our question, Lord, that why we were born in this world. And that's because, Lord, is to worship you alone. Lord, thank you, Lord, for reminding us, Lord, because we may have gone to a different path, Lord, na we may have forgotten, Lord, to worship you, Lord. Forgive us, Lord, sa aming mga pagkukulang sa inyo, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for loving us, Lord, for your unconditional love, Lord. Lord, thank you, Lord, for your patience, Lord, na mahaba yung pasensya niyo po sa amin, Lord, that even though we are sinners, we are unfaithful to you, Lord, but still, Lord, andyan ka pa rin po, Lord. Always na inaakay kami, Lord, and always reminding us, Lord, to go back to you, Lord, to repent for our sins and accept you, Lord Jesus Christ, as our Lord and Savior, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for saving us, Lord, from the wrong path. And thank you, Lord, for straightening our path, Lord, by revealing to us, Lord, your message, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Help us, Lord, to apply what we have learned this evening, Lord. To worship you, Lord, in spirit and in truth. To love you, Lord, with all of our heart, mind, and soul. And to bring glory to your name, Lord, in everything that we do, Lord. Thank you, Lord, so much, Lord, for your love, for your grace, and your mercy, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We love you, Lord, through your Son, in Jesus Christ's name. And all of us will say, Amen. Amen. Glory to God po. That's all lang po. Thank you for watching and God bless you. And to God be all the glory and praises. Bye.